what we are seeing here is the organic remains of a fossilized tree trunk, which was prevalent around 20 million years. We are finding multiple layers. One is this, one is this log, the second one is here. The other half, the other part is broken, but we can still see, and this is another one. So this one is one, this is another one, and then the third one is right here in front of us. Three logs of wood, huge logs of wood, I must say, are present here. And the 20 million year span is again turning out to be very crucial in terms of evolution and upliftment of Himalayas are concerned. These types of logs of wood cannot have flourished in environment or paleolatitudinal conditions beyond say Shimla, or beyond these latitudes which you are presently finding these fossils. The thickness of these, if it may be around a meter or so, you can see it must be from here till here to this line. So this is a huge thick logs of wood which we are finding here. So these logs of wood are not possible in the Himalayan conditions due to cold climatic conditions. We may not get these types of big diameter and huge trees. And these massive trees, if they are present here beyond this and then they are transported from the Himalayas, it doesn't make any sense, you know. Because if these trees are present in the Himalayas, which were existing before the sedimentation took place, and it is believed, generally believed, that these fossilized specimens along with these sediments were deposited in the fast sinking basin, and the source rock of these sediments is Himalayas. But this is not the case. This is not the case. Now we are getting these organic specimens. I've collected one. You see, very well preserved layers we are getting here. The bark, maybe it is possible for us to identify the generic and the specific name. If we are able to do that, I'm sure we will get affinities of these plant fossils which are very similar to the ones which we are finding in equatorial climatic conditions. Which, what does this mean? This means that these plants were flourishing along the equator or sub-equatorial climatic conditions. Then what happened? Then suppose this is China and this is India. So they were flourishing somewhere here. India drifted from Africa, so it moved and then it collided with these basins, you know, and then brought these basins along with other sediments, collided with the with the Chinese plate, and led to the evolution of the Himalayas. So what we are finding here today may not be present here, but they may have been grown near the equatorial climate, equator or sub-equatorial latitudinal positions. Then they might have transported due to the tectonic plate movement of the Indian plate, leading to accumulation of other sediments and finally making what we are seeing today as Himalayas. So presently we are seeing this in the massive channel sandstone fissures. Channel sandstone fissures is a typical channel sandstone fissures, and the uprooting of these huge tree trunks represents a massive flooding event in the past, and maybe correlated with the global warming, you know. Massive global warming taking place, uprooting all the trees, moving them along the channels, and then depositing there somewhere to be made fossils. And then these fossils again colliding with when the Indian plate collided with these basins, they moved the entire basin and moved the entire basin, and then we got moved this entire basin, and then we got collision with the Chinese plate, what we are seeing in the form of Himalayas today. So very interesting geology, very interesting phenomena which we are seeing, and very well preservation. But I'm sorry to state that there is no effort from the government side to preserve these well documented fossilized tree trunks, which have a history to tell about the evolution and upliftment of Himalayas. This will be, if preserved, they can be a great source of inspiration to the future generations to understand how the tectonic processes in the earth move, how oceans, once oceans becomes mountains. This is what is evident here. These were channels, oceans, and now we are seeing them in the form of Himalayan mountain ranges. So with these samples, I'm going to collect more samples. If you want, you can be with me, and I'm just going to do that. But I don't have a plastic bag, you know, where I can get these. So I'm just going to get some plastic fossilized specimens now.